The Mark of God, Friday, May 12th, 2017. I am the Lord God. I change not. I am he that caused Noah to build the ark, thereby saving 8 people, for Noah found grace in my sight. I destroyed that world for their rebellion against me. I am he that rained down fire and brimstone upon Sodom and Gomorrah and the surrounding cities for their abominations of sodomy. I scattered the nation of Israel to the 4 corners of the earth. I am he that sends wars upon nations that fight against the Lord. I raise up presidents, dictators, kings. I am he that removes them from power. I do all these things after the counsel of my own will, for I am the great God of heaven and earth. No one can stay my hand. Who is he that says you cannot do this? For I know better than the Almighty. They are all as grass that withers in the heat. None can save his own life. Soon I will judge the world again. For as I set the 7 colored rainbow in Noah's day as a token that I will not destroy by water anymore, now I will burn the earth by fire. I will waste the inhabitants of the earth that hate me. I will show my love and mercy to them that love the Lord, even them that cry and sigh for the abominations that are done upon the earth. My judgment shall stand first in my house. I will purify a people who trust the Lord no matter what he does to them. For they trust me even unto death. They are my crown jewels, for I have made them so. They will glorify me in the final hour. Their reward is great. I am the resurrection and the life. They that give their lives for me shall never be ashamed. I have given them a place to reign with me for eternity. Therefore, ye sons of men, fear the Almighty God, your Creator. Turn, turn from your wicked ways. Seek me while I can still be found. Give praise and honor and glory to him that sits on the throne. For I have set out my angel to mark them that sigh and cry for all the evil men has done upon the earth. There is another mark reserved for them that reject my goodness. It is the sum of all the perversions of sick minds that have worshipped Lucifer. I will thread them down in the fierceness of my wrath. My fury shall be poured out upon the unbelievers, for they cared not for righteousness, but have pleasure in their wickedness. Therefore, they will not be able to stand in the judgment of the righteous. I am the Prince of the earth, the Holy King of Israel. I am the Lord Jesus Christ. Greetings, saints. Welcome to Chaplain Peter 1. And this is a word I received from the Lord today. And I put it on for you so you can be able to read it. And there are the Bible references to it. In Genesis chapter 9, 11 to 15, this is in the time of Noah, and this is with the flood, with the 7 colored rainbow, not 6 colored like we use today for the homosexual movement, but the real 7 colored rainbow, which was a covenant between Noah and God that he should not flood the world no more. And then in Revelation 19, 5 to 25 is the historical event of Sodom and Gomorrah and 3 other cities where Lot lived, the nephew of Abraham, and where angels came to visit Sodom to see what was going on. And they have decided to destroy it for its wickedness. And they wanted to get Lot out of there, and they came to visit Lot. And the men of the city surrounded Lot's house, and they said, bring him out so we can know him. We can know these men. And they did not mean a handshake. They wanted to rape these men. This is the wickedness, which again we are seeing at this time. And so the angels blinded those men. They couldn't find the door. And Lot and his family went out. And the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah with sulfur fire. fire and brimstone. Lamentations is right after the book of Jeremiah, where Jeremiah is crying and lamentating for all the terrible destruction the Lord put upon Jerusalem in the time that Nebuchadnezzar came and surrounded him and made a siege, and there was no food, so they ran out of food. They started eating the animals, the horses, and then finally the mothers started to eat their children, their infants. The starvation was so bad. 2 Peter 3:3-9 also speaks about the judgment of God, that it must start first in the house of God, and that God has reserved it now to be judged by fire. No more just water, but he's reserved it to be judged by fire. And the Bible tells us that the judgment of God must start first in the house of God, because we are his people. He will start with us. So in Ezekiel 9:1-7 is where judgment starts. In the house of God, where Ezekiel has the vision and he sees the angel with the inkhorn, a writing tool. And the Lord says to him, go mark the men on the foreheads, mark them, that sigh and they cry for the abominations that are done in Jerusalem. And the Lord's doing the same thing today. He's marking us again before the final and great big judgment that's about to come upon the whole world, the whole earth. And we need to sigh and cry. Do you cry? Do you sigh? Do you have pain in your heart? Do you have groanings in your heart for the things that are going on in this world? And then the angel went out, but another angel came with slaughter weapons, and he started slaughtering everyone, from the 70 elders in the house all the way down all through Jerusalem, every man, woman, and child. The only ones that were spared were the ones that had the mark on them, mark of God. And Revelation 10:13 speaks about the power to overcome in these last days. It says they overcame them by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Revelation 13:14-18 speaks about the Antichrist, the beast, who blasphemes the tabernacle of God and them in heaven. And he causes rich and poor to receive a mark, that they might not be able to buy or sell unless they get the mark, his number or his name. And he's going to cause everyone on the earth who is not saved, who is not marked by God, whose names are not in the book of life, to worship the beast in the image of the beast. And then Revelation 19 is where the Lord comes back at the end. His robe is dipped in blood, not the blood of the cross, but the blood from the splattering of his enemies, because the blood will go up to the horse's shoulder, it says, to the bridle of a horse. And he shall dash him in pieces like with a potter's vessel. And on his robe, by his thigh, is written the word of God. And he is King of kings, and he's Lord of lords. Praise your holy name, Lord. And then Isaiah speaks about in 45:18-25, there is no other Savior but me. I am the Lord. It's the Lord Jesus Christ back there in the Old Testament. Read it yourself, saints. There is no other Savior. He is the rock, the Holy One of God. Philippians 2:5-11 speaks about every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. And that was taken from Isaiah 45:18-15. And again, the Apostle Paul repeats it in the Epistle to the Philippians. He was obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord, to the glory of the Father. Praise your holy name, Lord. And then finally, Revelation chapter 1. I'm going to read this one from my Bible and listen to the Lord, what the Apostle John wrote here. I want you to understand who the Lord Jesus Christ is, because this is not just some prophet or some messenger of God or some human apostle. It says here in Revelation chapter 1, we will start in verse 18, saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And what thou seest, write in a book, and send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia, unto Ephesus, unto Smyrna, to Pergamos, unto Thyatira, unto Sardis, unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. And I turned to see the voice that spake with me. And he being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks, which are the seven churches. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like the Son of Man, clothed in a garment down to the foot, and girt about the paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hairs were like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burnt in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. And he had in his right hand the seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shining in his strength. And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead. And he laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys of hell and death. Write these things which thou hast seen, the things which are, and the things which shall be hereafter. So this is who we're dealing with. And you that hate the Lord, or you couldn't care less, and you think you got it together with science and other stuff, you don't know real science. You're dealing with mystics. You're dealing with sorcery. You don't know what you're talking about, because man was created. It's obvious. And he's a holy God. And wrath of God is about to come on the United States and the world for our sins, for our abortions, for the homosexuality, for all these things, saints, for the pedophilia, for the government being full of this, for the Satan worship. God help us, saints. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you, Lord. You're worthy, Lord. Father, help us to resist the mark when it comes out, and rather to die for you. Help us to understand that we've been called to suffer to you. We've been put this on this earth to glorify you. Because as they hated you, they will hate us. As you were persecuted, we will be persecuted. And your word in Matthew 24 says we will be hated of all nations. And they're going to put us up in front of their courts, and they're going to afflict us, and they're going to murder us. And so, Lord, we have a martyr's crown if this should happen to us. Help us to be faithful unto the end. And we thank you. In the precious name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. I love you, saints, and the Lord loves you. God bless you.